WPBF 25 First Alert Forecast, certified by WeatherRate as our area's most accurate.
All right, happy Monday, everyone. And as we get outside again, the clouds keeping things a little bit on the gloomy side. We got a lot around the changes to talk about. Today's high temperature officially at PBIA, 78 degrees. This morning's low was a little cooler into the upper 60s, so we said goodbye to the muggy mid-70s. You can see the average high for this time of year. We should be at 75. We got some good news for that as the forecast will continue to show some cooler changes. We'll get to that in just a little bit. But as this Monday evening continues again, look at the clouds again. It's really socked in and bugging us as we go from the west coast of Florida out towards Fort Myers. We take you to South Florida again. The clouds continue to stream in. Not going to rule out one or two showers in the forecast tonight. Very light showers possible, but you can see again, mostly cloudy skies as we go through the evening time. And temperatures are slowly but surely falling into the 60s. Look at this, already into the low 60s in Sebastian. Fellsmere, 63 degrees. Also into Bassinger, 66 currently in Okeechobee, 66 also for our friends in towards Jensen Beach, and 67 Indiantown. Palm Beach County we go. Look at this. Temperatures again cooling down just a little bit. 69 Jupiter, 70 Lake Worth, Manalapan, 73 degrees in Boca Raton, and looking at 70 degrees right now as we check you out in Belgrade. So forecast for this evening, again, no problems. Temperatures upper 60s to right around 70 degrees. Mostly cloudy skies, and again, the isolated sprinkle in the forecast as this front is sitting just to our south. And as we go through Tuesday, it's just in the vicinity where we still got to keep a slight rain chance in the forecast. But generally, we're going to keep with the clouds, but that changes as we go through Wednesday into Thursday. So here's a look at future track. Let me walk you hour by hour. Here's a look at Tuesday morning. So you can see, again, mostly cloudy conditions as we start your Tuesday morning. But future track really not picking up on any kind of rain. So it looks like a dry commute. We could also see some areas of patchy fog inland. So I want you to be careful about that, especially if you're taking up I-95 up towards the Treasure Coast. And then as we head through the afternoon, future track agrees with us. Mostly cloudy skies, one or two showers possible. Rain chance tomorrow stands at about 20% to 30%. On the water, it's getting a little rough out there. Right behind this last cold front, small craft caution, seas running 4 to 6 feet. And looking at choppy conditions on the intercoastal waterways. So as we go through tonight in the morning, temperatures a little bit cooler into the mid to upper 60s. Patchy fog again with the north-northeasterly wind running between, say, 5 and 10 miles per hour. So not too breezy out there. And as we take a look at South Florida's most accurate forecast, proven as we go through the Palm Beaches and Treasure Coast. Look at this. Again, temperature's not bad. Very comfortable as we go through Tuesday. So this is New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. We're into the upper 70s. So again, slow and gradual warm up, a 30% chance for rain. And then a warm day on Thursday. That always happens because we're expecting a big cool front, because Thursday night into Friday is when it turns interesting as that cold front comes through. Look at that high on Friday, only 70 degrees after waking up to the 60s. And right now, as we see it, this upcoming weekend is looking spectacular with temperatures in the mid-70s and 60s to get you outside the door. All right, let's talk about this. This fancy graphic.
Look,
yeah,
like that.
New Year's Eve, low 70s. So we're talking about 11 o'clock midnight, a few clouds out there, and a chance for an isolated sprinkle, but right now it looks dry.